Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for our Travel on Bursary webinar. I'm Leanne, I work for marketing and I'll be overseeing this webinar today. And also in the background is my colleague Simon, who is helping me with that. Delivering your webinar today will be Katie from Harlow College. So how this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them alongside any information they wish to share on screen. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you. However, you will be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this will be at the bottom of your screen. If you're using a mobile device, tap the screen and it will appear at the top. Someone will either answer your questions live or answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask your questions as we go along and we will save some time at the end of the topics to answer as many as we possibly can. We are recording this webinar and you will receive an email with a link to the recording. This will also be available on the virtual applicant hub on the Harlow College website. I'm now going to hand you over to Katie for the first of our three topics.
Hi everyone, my name's Katie and I'm the Bursary Funds Coordinator at Harlow College. I'll be taking you through our first webinar today, Am I Eligible to Receive Bursary? So I will take you through a short presentation, but as Leanne mentioned, if you have any questions along the way, feel free to type them in the Q&A section and we will answer them at the end. So I'm just going to share with you the first slide of our presentation. Okay, so for those of you who don't already know, the bursary fund is provided to us by the government so that we can help support families that need help to send their child to college, whether that's with help with travel getting into college or help for the equipment and uniform that you need for the course. Here at Harlow College, we have what we call different tiers of bursary. And depending on the tier that you qualify for, this will depend on what kind of support that you can receive. So I'll take you through those tiers now. First of all, we have our bursary for vulnerable groups. So you can see here on the left, there's different categories that you would fall into that would make you eligible for this tier. So it could be that you are in care, a care leaver, in receipt of income support, universal credit, or employment support allowance and disability living allowance together. If you are in one of those categories and you also do need financial help to get to college, then you should be able to receive the support here shown on the right-hand side of the screen. Just a note about the benefits that we've mentioned, these would need to be in the student's name for this particular tier, not the parent's name. Next, we move on to our tier 1 and 2 for those who are aged 16 to 18. These two tiers are based on your total household income. So if this falls below 16,190 per year, then you should qualify for our tier 1. And you can see the support available on this tier on the left. If your household income is above 16,190, but is under 25,000 per year, then you should be able to get our tier 2 support, which is mentioned on the right here. The tier 2 has slightly less support than tier 1, just in the fact that you would get reduced travel costs. We would still cover all of the uniform and equipment for the course, but regards to educational visits, we'd usually contribute 50% of the cost of these. With regards to the age, you would be eligible if you're 16 to 18. However, if you're 19 and you have an EHCP, or if you started a 2-year course when you were 18, you would still be eligible for these two tiers. If you are 19 or over, then you might be qualifying for one of our 19 plus bursaries. So this is also based on household income. So if you're 19 or over and you earn below 25,000 per year in your household, then you should be able to get the support here on the left. If you have qualified for an advanced learner loan and your household income is under 25,000, you may be able to get our Learn Alone bursary, which provides slightly more support. It does mention their childcare assistance. With regards to this, if you're 20 or over, we can, and you qualify for bursary, we can help with childcare assistance. This is a separate application form, but if you indicate on your bursary application that you need this help, then we'll contact you with the application form at a later date. If you're under 20 and you need childcare assistance, the government actually do a Care to Learn scheme where they will fund this for you. So I have included the link to this at the bottom of the screen, so you can visit that to be able to find out more information. And when you apply for bursary, we will ask to see evidence documents for whichever tier you qualify for. So if it's the vulnerable bursary, we may need to see the looked after status letter confirmation, or we'd need to see a copy of the benefit letter that's in the student's name. If it's one of the other tiers, we usually just need to see evidence of the benefit. Some of them we ask for the last 3 month statements. Some of them we may ask just for the year, such as a tax credits award notice is a yearly thing. This is similar also for the 19 plus, but with the Learn Alone bursary, we'll need to see the letter of confirmation that you've been approved for the Advanced Learn Alone. And lastly, I have just included an example of a universal credit statement. For this, we do accept a screenshot of an online statement for the last 3 months, or if you've got paper copies, we'll accept a clear photo of this or a scan. Either of those will be fine. Okay, so that brings us to the end of our first webinar. Now we'll go through the question and answer section and just see if there's any questions that we need to answer now. Okay, so there's no questions at the moment. I'll just wait a couple of minutes, see if any come through. Okay, so I can see one question's come through. With the DBS check, if you qualify for bursary, we would usually cover the cost of that DBS check. So if you just apply for bursary as soon as possible, and then we'll be able to help out with that nearer to the time. I see a question. Will a link be available to apply for the bursary? Yes, what we'll be doing is sending out an email that has a link to the bursary application. More information on this will be covered in our next webinar as well, if you want to know a bit more about that. But the email will go to the student's email address in the first instance. Okay, so I think that looks like all of the questions for this webinar. So what I'll do now is hand you back to Leanne.
Okay, hi everyone. Katie, I've seen we've just had a question come through. If you wouldn't mind answering that for Brian, that would be great. The question is, do we have to apply through student email and not the parent email?
Oh yeah, I've just seen that, sorry. So the email will come through on the student's email. However, once you click the link, you can fill it out as a parent or together with the student, that's fine. I'll have to double check, but it may be that we'll copy the parents in as well. But you'll definitely be able to get access to that either way.
Okay, thank you so much for that, Katie. Okay, so we have a few minutes before the next session. So we're just going to wait until 2:15, just in case any new attendees join. So we will wait until 2:15 and then Katie will explain how to complete a bursary application. So we'll see you all in a few minutes. Okay, welcome back everyone. We're going to move on to our next topic now, and welcome to any new attendees that have joined us today. Delivering your webinar will be Katie from Harlow College. So how this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them alongside any information they wish to share via screen sharing. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you, however you will be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this will be at the bottom of your screen, and if you're using a mobile device, tap the screen and the Q&A feature will appear at the top. Someone will either answer your question live or answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask as many questions as you can as we go along, but we will save some time at the end of the topics to answer as many as we possibly can live. We are recording this webinar and you will receive an email with a link to the recording. This will also be available on the Virtual Applicant Hub on the Harlow College website. I'm now going to hand you over to Katie for our second of the three topics.
Hi to any new ones that have joined, and to those that have come from the last webinar, welcome back. I'll be taking you through the second webinar of the day, how do I complete a bursary application? So as Leanne mentioned, if you have any questions whilst we're going through, feel free to type them in on the Q&A section and we'll answer them at the end. Okay, so this year, the application for bursary will be done online. What will happen is that the email will come through. This should be on or around the 1st of August, and it will come from this admissions email address shown here. And this will include a link to the bursary application. If you haven't received it around this time, please double check your junk or spam folders, because sometimes it may go in there. And if you still haven't received it, feel free to contact us on this bursary email address or this admissions email address, and we'll make sure that you can get that link. So when you go to complete the application, these are the things that you will need with you. Obviously, you'll need a computer, tablet, or smartphone to complete the application on. You'll need an internet connection, the email that contains the link, and lastly, you will need electronic copies of your evidence documents. We will accept a photo if this is a paper document, as long as the photo is really super clear and we can see the whole page, that's fine. At the moment, we are still in the process of creating this application, so we don't have the screenshots to show you exactly what it will look like, but I can tell you the types of questions that you'll be asked in the application. So it will ask you what college you'll be attending. It will ask you for your learner details. Some of these may be pre-filled in from your application form, in which case we just would ask that you double check the information is correct there. We'll also ask you travel details, so how you plan to get to college, and it may be that we ask what your nearest bus or train station is. One of the questions may ask if any of these categories apply to you. This is just so that we can determine whether you're eligible for the bursary for vulnerable groups. So if you know that one of these applies to you, just tick next to it on the application. These benefits here would be in the learner's name for this tier, not the parent's name. It may ask if you've been approved for an advanced learner loan. This is just for the 19 plus applicants only. It will also ask what type of evidence you will be supplying with your application. So it will give you a list of what we can accept. So you just need to tick next to it which ones you're going to upload. Lastly, it may ask whether you require childcare assistance. For now, this will just be a yes or no question. So if you qualify for bursary and you tick yes, then we will send you more information on that nearer to the time. This will probably be around enrolment, because you will need to know how many days you'll be attending college for the application form. And that brings us to the end of our second webinar. I'll just have a look to see whether there's any questions on this particular one. Okay, so there's none at the moment. We'll just wait a couple of minutes to see if any come through. And if not, I'll hand you back to Leanne. Okay, I can see a question here. What if I've been furloughed and I don't know for how long? That's absolutely fine. We will be considering all that's been going on with the COVID situation. And we will take into account what you're currently getting, what you'd usually get if things were in normal circumstances. But we understand that things are quite difficult at the moment with a lot of people. So we'll take that into account and make a decision based on your current circumstances. Okay, I can see another question. What if I have more than one child? So if you have more than one child that's attending the college, you can obviously apply for bursary for all of these. If this question is to do with childcare, we do offer assistance with childcare for all of your children, but it is capped at a weekly amount. Okay, so a question, what if I can't find my benefit evidence? So it's a bit of a tricky one because we do need to see some kind of evidence of what you're receiving. Your best option would be maybe to get in touch either online or over the phone with the government to see if you can get that resent through. It may just take a little longer to be able to process your application, but the good thing about this year is we're starting those applications a bit earlier, so it'll give you time to get the information that you need for that. Okay, so we had a question about the self-employment grant. I understand that there was one recently and there may be another one in August. So what we'll have to do, I think, is wait until, just send through the evidence that you have already, what you've received in the grant. I understand that the grant itself was about 80% of normal earnings. So we will base it on a mixture of the grant that you've had, maybe last year's earnings as well, to give us a general idea of what your income usually is. Okay, will I get help with travel to and from college? Yes, most of the bursary tiers do contribute towards travel. For some of the higher tiers, we would usually cover the total cost of your travel to get into college. Some of the lower tiers, we might offer half of the cost of this, but we'll definitely help you in some way. Okay, another question, do I get help with trip costs? Yes, educational visit costs are included in most of the bursary tiers. It's usually just for the 16 to 18. I don't think the 19 plus includes this, but for the 16 to 18 tiers, we do contribute towards educational visits, as long as they're essential to the course. Okay, I think that might be all of the questions. So I'll just pass you now back to Leanne.
Hi everyone. We have a couple of minutes again before the next topic. That starts at 2:30. And we're going to wait until 2:30 just in case we have any more attendees drop in. So we will wait and we will see you then. Okay, welcome back everyone. We're going to move on to our next topic now, and welcome to any new attendees that has joined us. Delivering your webinar today will be Katie from Harlow College. So how this webinar will work is our presenters will share their information with you. They can't see you, but you should be able to see them alongside any information they wish to share on screen. Our presenters and other attendees can't hear you. However, you will be able to ask questions throughout the webinar using the Q&A feature. If you're using a computer, this Q&A feature will be at the bottom of your screen. And if you're using a mobile device, tap your screen and this will appear at the top. Someone will either answer your questions live or they will answer it on the Q&A feed. Ask your questions as we go along, ask as many as you can, but we will save some time at the end of the topics to answer as many as we possibly can live. We are recording this webinar and you will receive an email with the link to the recording. This will also be available on the Virtual Applicant Hub on the Harlow College website. So now I'm going to hand you over to Katie for the last of our topics for this session.
Just realised I was muted. Welcome everyone to our last webinar, Planning a Journey to College Using Public Transport. My name's Katie and I'm the Bursary Funds Coordinator at Harlow College. So I'll just take you through a short presentation, but if you have any questions whilst we're going through, as Leanne said, feel free to type them in the Q&A section and we'll answer them at the end. Okay, so my first suggestion when you're planning a route to college is to use an online map service. I have used Google Maps as an example. It's very easy to use. You just need to type in your home address at the top and the college address at the bottom. And it will, if you click this icon at the top, it will give you any public transport routes that it knows does this route for you. So for example, from the Three Horseshoes to Harlow College, it's given us three different route options. We've got the quickest route, which shows that you'd have to get a number 7 bus, then you'd have to change over and get the 509 510. If you were to click on details, this also opens up more detail on the route itself, on the timings and the bus operators, for example. It also gives us other options. The second option just involves one bus the whole way, and the last option is a bus and a train. So you can pick basically the one that fits in the best with your college times. For those of you at Stansted Airport College, the Stansted Commuter Centre offer a discounted travel card to all airport staff. They've also kindly agreed to let our students be able to purchase that as well. So at the top of the screen, this is the Stansted Commuter website, so feel free to visit that for a bit more information. But this here is the map of the routes available on this card. You can see that it's colour-coded. These colours are different zones and they are different prices. So the table on the left shows you which colour is the different price. I've also included a table of the bursary contributions that we provide towards these travel cards. So you can see based on the tier how much we would contribute to those. Just a quick note on these. We do suggest if you're going to buy one that you purchase a monthly one first. This is just so that if you were to change your mind about the course or you wanted to go down a slightly different route, you've only paid for a month. Because the commuter centre don't tend to offer refunds for 1 month and 3 month travel cards. Once that month's over, if you're still attending the college, you can then go on to buy 3 monthly travel cards because they do work out a bit cheaper. We do also offer a college bus route run through Anita's. If you go to this web address at the top, it will give you more information about this, or you can Google Harlow College Travel. These are the two routes that we currently run. We've picked a lot of these towns because they tend to have not as often public transport routes that stop there. So it will, our bus will stop once in the morning at these times shown, and then it will collect once from the college to go home. So just a note that you will need to be on time for these buses, because if you miss it, you won't be able to catch it again. Last year, the cost for these routes were £500 for the year. And we're hoping to keep this the same, but it is subject to change. When you get your enrolment pack through, this should have instructions on how to apply for a seat on the bus, because you do have to apply for this because the spaces do tend to get taken up. And now we'll move on to discounts. You'll find that a lot of companies offer student discounts on travel. These are available to you whether you're a bursary student or not. You just simply Google the company and they usually make it quite clear what student discounts they offer. I've included a few examples. A lot of them do things called rail cards. This is where you'd pay a yearly one-off fee and then they provide you a card which gets a discount off of standard fares. So for example, the National Rail Saver, you pay a yearly £30 fee and that gets you 50% off standard rail fares. So it is quite handy to have. What I'll do is I'll leave that up on the screen just for a minute more in case you want to take a photo of that to refer back to. Whilst I'm doing so, I'll just mention the Arriva bus. We have an agreement with them on what we call a smart card. So you'd be able to pick up a smart card on your enrolment day. And what this allows you to do is to buy a discounted ticket on a mobile app. It's a lot easier to use and you'll immediately be able to get that discount. So it's quite handy. Okay, so that brings us to the end of our travel webinar. Thank you for listening. I'll just now see if there are any questions that need to be answered in the Q&A section. Okay, so I can see we've had one already answered. Someone's asked, with a travel card, do you get a discount even if you don't apply for bursary? If you're referring to the Stansted Commuter Centre travel card, the prices that I showed on the table is the already discounted price. They offer an 80% discount on standard fares. So once you've paid for the travel card, you've already paid for the fares on that route. Okay, so there's been a question, is car travel possible to Stansted College? Yes, you can drive to Stansted Airport College. Although there is a car park at the college, at the moment students cannot park there just because it is such a small car park. However, there is a hotel across the road called the Novotel. They at the moment offer us discounted parking tickets for our students, and this is £6 a day. So if you decide to park there, you need to let the college know. You'd pay on our online payment system called WisePay for the ticket, and then you would collect that from Stansted Airport College reception when you leave for the day. So will the bursary cover petrol money? It depends on your situation for public transport. Usually public transport is the cheapest way to get to college, so we would encourage that. However, if you live in a town where there isn't easy access to public transport, we will consider offering a contribution towards petrol money. With regards to the question about bursary, will I get bursary travel before my first day? We would recommend that you apply for bursary as soon as possible online, because we will let you know beforehand whether you will be eligible for this. However, usually it will be available for enrolment day. So as soon as you're enrolled on the course, if you've been pre-approved for bursary, we'll be able to let you know what your next steps are with getting that discounted travel. Okay, there's a question. Someone's mentioned that their son's never used public transport before, so they're a bit concerned. Yeah, that's understandable. A lot of students come to college and it is their first time using public transport. If it's possible for you to do so, I'd probably recommend doing a trial run beforehand with them. Maybe get on that bus or get on that train with them, make sure they're familiar with the route. Then it'll make it a lot easier on their first day without them having to worry about the route. They'll be able to get into college on time fine. Okay, is there free parking for students at Harlow College? There isn't free parking. However, there is a car park just across the road from Harlow College. So I don't believe it is as expensive as the car park at Stansted Airport College. It's worth having a research online. They may have put their prices up from the last ones I knew, but it's not. I don't believe it's too expensive. Someone's asked, how do I get from the terminal to Stansted Airport College? So a lot of the public transport routes do stop at the airport rather than the college. So once you get to the airport, there's going to be a college bus running in the morning and afternoon that will take you from the terminal to the college. But there's also an Arriva route that does that run as well. It's the 509 or the 510. So they run quite regularly. You can also catch that from the terminal and that goes to the college bus stop. I'll just wait to see if any further questions come through.
Okay, thank you very much everyone for joining us today. We hope you've got a lot out of today's session. If you do have any questions that haven't been asked or you go away and you think of something else, please take note of this email address that's on your screen now. We will drop you an email with this session recording. And we would really appreciate if you could spend a couple of minutes filling out our survey so we can continue to improve this service. Now we're going to hang on for the next 5 minutes or so, just in case you want to get any more last minute questions in, and we will answer them on the Q&A feed rather than answering them live. So just drop those questions into the Q&A feed if you've got any last minute ones. We're going to stick around, but thank you very much for joining. Bye.